My name is Ojala Jonah, and I'm very glad to welcome you on this YouTube channel where we are going basically to deal with religious issues. And in today's episode, we are going to majorly focus on the rise of Christianity. Before we go deep into our discussion today, I'd like us to define our key word, and that is Christianity. What is Christianity? Christianity is the faith in the person of Jesus Christ. Therefore, our story of Christian religion will begin with the life of Jesus Christ, whom today, more than 2,000 years after his earthly ministry, the faith in him has spread all over the globe. It is this Jesus who founded the church, and he actually began his public ministry in the 15th year reign of Tiberius Caesar when he left Nazareth in order to encompass the whole Israel with the kingdom message. Throughout his teaching, he exhibited authority in his words, deeds, as he was teaching the people of Galilee, and then he moved on to the inhabitants of Palestine. But depending on the kind of mission he wanted to execute, he really needed manpower. So, out of his many disciples, he chose 12 men whom he called apostles. And these are Simon Peter, James and John, sons of Zebedee, Philip, Andrew, Bartholomew, Thaddeus, Judas Iscariot, Matthew, Simon the Zealot, and James, son of Alphaeus. So, it's evident that actually Jesus founded the church before his death, when he said to Peter, "You are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it." Actually, he went ahead to put Peter in charge of the church that he had newly formed when he told him that, "You, Peter, feed my sheep, feed my lamb." And therefore, that's the reason as to why Peter is considered as the first pope. Well, the actual founding of the church was completed on the day of Pentecost, when the disciples became bold and determined to proclaim the gospel after being filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. And it's believed that on that day, 3,000 people joined the family of Christianity on the day of Pentecost. Well, most of us keep on talking about Pentecost. What is the actual meaning of Pentecost? Well, let me help you define Pentecost. Pentecost is a Greek word which means the 50th day, and it was basically used by Greek writers for the second of the three pilgrimage festivals stipulated in the Old Testament. And basically you can find this in Exodus chapter 34 verses 22. And these festivals were: number 1, Festival of Unleavened Bread; number 2, Festival of Weeks with the First Fruits of Wheat Harvest; and number 3, Festival of Ingathering at the turn of the year. Therefore, Pentecost provided the disciples with a worldwide audience, as large numbers had come to Jerusalem for the pilgrimage holiday. Therefore, Pentecost marked the beginning of the wheat harvest. Well, the disciples were able to preach the gospel to the crowd that had gathered in the city from all parts of the world, and this included the Parthians, Medes, Elamites, people from Cappadocia, Pontus, Asians, Phrygians, Pamphylians, Egyptians, people from Nubia, especially near Cyrene, visitors from Rome, Cretans, and Arabs. The faith in Jesus Christ was based on the fact that God chose to reveal himself through Jesus Christ, and that his words, deeds, death, and resurrection were a manifestation of God's existence. Therefore, this constitutes the Christian religion and its beginnings. However, many Jews feared the new religion, so they went ahead to attack it as a crude and futile faith which was among the peasants of Galilee, and these Jews tried as much as they could to destroy the new faith. Well, when we read in Acts chapter 17 and verses 32, Paul preaches about Jesus and some Greeks in Athens laugh at him, but a group of Jews from Galilee who had come to believe that Jesus was the Christ, the long-awaited Messiah, and that he was the one who was long foretold by their prophets, and they worshipped him as their God. And that he was the one who was long foretold by their prophets, they ended up worshipping him as their God. Surprisingly, they also fearlessly began proclaiming their faith among fellow Jews. As a result, the new religion spread like fire, and communities of Christians sprang up like mushrooms in towns and the countryside. In these new communities, Jews lived with Gentiles, men mixed with women, peasants with the rich, slaves with the masters, and the educated with the uneducated, which made Christianity to have a universal appeal. And in this regard, Christianity emerged as a separate entity from the religion of Judaism. Thank you for watching this episode, and please do not hesitate to subscribe, comment, and share if you have liked our content. Well, I just want to let you know that in the next episode, we are going to look at Judaism and the reason as to why Christianity separated from Judaism.